.com update. I'm Chief Meteorologist Tony Bonolfi. Broad area of low pressure now spinning here in the western Gulf of Mexico is adding a lot of clouds across the Gulf of Mexico and here across the Florida Peninsula. High pressure, though, is going to try to build in over the next couple of days and push everything west of us and increase our sunshine while also increasing our temperatures by the time we get to Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Out the door temperatures tomorrow, really not that bad. 66 in Ocala, 69 here in Orlando, back towards Titusville. In Melbourne, 70 to about 73 degrees. The Tuesday afternoon setup has that big ridge of high pressure parked across the eastern side of the peninsula. That means that we get that return east to east southeasterly flow. So just watch yourselves at the beaches. The rip currents are still going to be there, but the temperatures are going to be very comfortable, 80 to 85 along the coast, middle 80s as you work your way in through the interior. And that's significant because typically speaking, average highs are up around 90 tomorrow, even at the beaches. Very comfortable afternoon. 82 to 83 degrees. Seas are going to still be a little stirred up out there offshore, but on the intercoastal waterways, we're looking at a light chop. So Wednesday, more of a southerly flow now, getting back to normal temperature-wise. By Thursday, a south-southwesterly flow. That means that those temperatures will be building. And then by Friday, not only are the temperatures building, the moisture begins to build, and that means those afternoon showers and thunderstorms are going to be put right back into the afternoon forecast equation. Tropically speaking, day two of the Atlantic hurricane season, the Atlantic is very quiet. Not the case, however, here across the eastern Pacific. We've got a broad area of low pressure that is formed into Tropical Depression 2E. Latest computer model trends take this north and then eventually west. If that pans out, then there's no issues with anything developing in the Gulf of Mexico. A lot of our computer models, long range, a la next Monday or Tuesday, are taking some amalgamation of this entity and producing some significant rainfall across portions of the Gulf of Mexico. Way too early to tell what's going to be happening with that. Of course, we'll keep you posted right here at WESH 2. Forecast now the next couple of days. Big story, the building heat and the building rain chances by Friday, Saturday, and again on Sunday.